Okay, so independence movements. This is the Vietnam breakdown. Ho Chi Minh was the main dude. I'm sure you all remember him. Was he a communist using nationalism? Or was he a nationalist using communism? Who knows? Definitely not me. You should have an opinion about this, probably. It's a big historical thing where the historians debate it. And you gotta have reasons why you go along with either side if you're gonna debate this. I have not gotten there yet, 'cause I am not that prepared. So they wanted independence from France, the Vietnamese did, who took them back in the good old 1885. But after the Japanese defeated Russia in 1904, and the Bolshevik Revolution happened in 1917, and China became communist in 1949, the people were like, let's do this. And they decided to start a revolution because, you know, the Japanese defeating Russia was like, oh, smaller places can fight against the, I don't want to say Europeans, I almost said Europeanist, I don't know, the West, the grand old West. And then the Bolshevik Revolution and the China become communist was like, communism is a way to get there. But, you know, Ho Chi Minh got rejected at the Paris Peace Conference the first time he proposed independence after World War I. And then he came back home and was like, yo, I studied communism and we're gonna do that. And he decided that we're gonna take away the farmland from the rich people and distribute it to everyone. And the people were a little conflicted. 'Cause like Ho Chi Minh declared independence in 1945, but the Japanese were occupying them at the time he declared independence. Like, as far as the Japanese were concerned, they were very much not independent. They were very much still colonized, and they were colonized by the Japanese now instead of the French. But eventually the Japanese were able to be moved out by the revolutionaries. And they were like, yay, independence, now let's start stuff internally. And all the peasants sighed. So it was the North versus the South, and this Civil War thing started. The Viet Minh were Ho Chi Minh's super cool military unit, and by super cool, I mean most people living there did whatever they could to help whatever soldiers were in the neighborhood, including US soldiers, because otherwise the soldiers were generally just really shitty to them and the peasants could face horrible, horrible things. So they sided with whoever was in the neighborhood. It was a fun time for any peasant living there. In 1954, the Genevian Accords is where a bunch of Western dudes got together to be ignorant dads and not listen to their sons. Could you classify Vietnam as two different people at that point? I don't know. Anyway, they split the North and the South, and they intended for them to be reunited later. Ha ha ha! That went so well. The North was Ho Chi Minh, and the South was Diem, and you can remember this because Diem starts with a D, and so does down, so Diem is down south. I thought of that just when I was writing this script. It's kind of a script. So that I could remember it, because I always forget which way Ho Chi Minh was. Ho Chi Minh was north, because he was. And Diem was south, because he's down south Diem. I don't know if I'm pronouncing his name right. Anyways, Ho Chi Minh was problematically militaristic, but Diem did some shit too. Diem refused to hold the elections his Western dads had told him to in the Genevian Accords, and made a bunch of hamlets that the people didn't want, which were like the small towns we talked about, because he was saying that they would stop the guerrilla warfare that was taking over, but really it just wasted a bunch of resources, and he made them pay rent, and he wasn't a big fan of people opposing him, so he arrested those too, just like every other dictator. Ho Chi Minh did the same shit to his enemies that Diem was doing it. Anyway, down south, Diem targeted the Viet Minh, and the southern communists that were called the Viet Cong. And also, before writing this and looking this all this up in order to write these points, I thought those were the same thing, the Viet Minh and the Viet Cong. So I looked it up just for you and me. You being all you buddies out there who actually decided to give this a listen. for God knows what reason. The Viet Minh was their name when they were fighting the French for independence. And after they got independence, some of them became the guerrilla fighting Viet Cong. So not all of them transitioned over, but a good enough portion did, that if you look at it as the Viet Minh became the Viet Cong after they gained independence, that's pretty much what you need to know. They were communists. Yay. Right. Okay. Continuing. Down south, Diem was Catholic, and Ho Chi Minh was Buddhist, but also communists shouldn't have religion, so I don't really know what that was about. Catholics were the minority for the Vietnam area, but down south, Diem was real crappy about that, and he gave them a lot of perks. Anyway, Diem was assassinated in 1963, and Ho Chi Minh lived until 1969, so 6 more years, suck it, Diem. Down south, Diem was replaced by General, I think that's Thieu, T-H-I-E-U, and he was also corrupt. History is problematic. And just a point that I wanted to put in there, this started as the Indochina War because Vietnam was pushed together with other nationalities during the French rule, and those were two parts. So, like, the Vietnam War was after they gained their independence. Before that, it's not the same thing. It's just not. The Vietnam War has to do with the U.S. getting involved in the Civil War going on, and the Indochina War was what they were doing to gain their independence. And also, we have to know a bunch of junk that happened after Ho Chi Minh died, so we can talk about the effects and all that. In 1976, the country was reunified into the Socialist Republic of Vietnam. So the communist Ho Chi Minh dreamed of. Or did he? And then there was also a 10-year period of collectivization, during which the Cong An, a secret police peoples, enforced the state's will. All art and literature created before 1975, which was the start of this 10-year period, was banned, and the peasants were not happy, but then again, when was this war ever helpful for them? But in 1986, they stopped that shit with, I think it's pronounced Doi Moi, D-O-I space M-O-I, renovation, because they were having shortages on pretty much everything, so they brought back a capitalist economy into their socialist state in order to not have everyone starve and die. Is this what Ho Chi Minh wanted? Is this what America, land of the free, wanted? Who knows? I do not. I know so little. But I know this much, and I'm going to try and remember it all. Bare minimum, guys. Just, we got this.